Hi everybody, how's everybody doing today? Hopefully everybody's having a fantastic day. Before we get started, hi, my name is Teresa and I welcome you all to my channel. If you're new here and you like unboxing, so you like getting ready with me with some scary ghost stories, even doing makeup try-ons on here, I do animal and nature clips, I do a walk in history, I do Mass Monday Ladies Collab, I sometimes do giveaways on this channel, and guys, I do more. I do random more than just beauty on this channel. Now if you're interested in all the content that I just said, then please be considering hitting the subscribe button down here on the bottom. When you hit the subscribe button, there'll be a bell. And when you hit the bell, you'll be notified of when I upload my new video. So today, guys, we are taking a walk in the history, and we are on state Iowa, our 15th state out of the 50. I have been doing all the 50 states, if you're new here, about their bio, the history, the birthday, and three creepy ghost stories at the end. Now, the reason why I like doing a walk in history is because I love everything about history. I like going into places like old homes, abandoned homes. I like going into museums with their artifacts. I like going to forts. I like going to anywhere that has to involve with history, like the battlefields in PA and all those places. I've always been intrigued with history since I was young. It's been one of my best subjects in school, and now I want to go over with all of you guys about our states and learn more, a little bit more about each of them. So, like I said, today we are doing Iowa. This is our 15th state, and we call this state the Hawkeye State. So what I do is I start with the bio first, and then I get to the history, then the birthday, and then the three ghost stories at the end. The reason why I do three ghost stories, because what's a good ghost story? And ghosts could tell you stories that they could tell you about what happened back then. If you're a non-believer, I do understand. All you have to do is just skip over and just go to the end. But if you would like to stay and listen to the bio and the history and their birthday, please stay tuned for that. So let's go ahead and get started. So the bio that I start with first, it goes from nicknames, state capital, birds, flowers, trees, what you can think of, I got it written down. Now the bio was kind of short on this state. I couldn't find any more information. So if you are from Iowa and you can give me a little bit more information on your bio, just leave me messages down below because I love hearing from all of you. All right, so let's go ahead and get started with the bio. So the nickname for the state is the Hawkeye State. The state motto is our liberties we prize and our rights we will maintain. The state anthem is the Song of Iowa. The state capital is Des Moines. The state bird is an eastern goldfinch. The state flower is a prairie rose. The state tree is a bur oak. And the state rock is geode. And like I said, that was a little bit of bio information I could find on the state. So now we are moving on to the history part. And what I do with the history part is I read through all of it, and not to make it so long. So I find a paragraph and I would write that, and then another paragraph underneath that that sounds more interesting. Instead of have to go all over the history, which one day I hope to do just a bunch of history reading for you guys on the state, because I find these very interesting. I find them amazing, and I just love learning about the history of each state. So let's go ahead and get started. When American Indians first arrived in what is now Iowa more than 13 years ago, they were hunters, gatherers, living in a pleistocene glacial landscape. By the time European explorers and traders visited Iowa, American Indians were largely settled farmers with complex economic, social, and political systems. Iowa has a long tradition of state and county fairs. The first and second Iowa state fairs were held in more developed eastern part of the state at Fairfield. In 1917, the United States entered World War I, and farmers as well as all Iowans experienced a wartime economy for farmers. The change was significant. Since the beginning of the war in 1914, Iowa farmers had experienced economic prosperity, which lasted until the end of the war. In the economic sector, Iowa also had undergone considerable change, beginning with the first industries developed in 1830, which were mainly for processing materials growing in the area. Iowa has experienced a gradual increase in the number of business and manufacturing operations. The transition from an agricultural economy to a mixed economy happened slowly. The Great Depression and World War II accelerated the shift away from the smallholder farming to large farmers and began a trend of urbanization. The period after World War II witnessed a particular increase in manufacturing operations. And that's a little bit that I wrote down for the history. And like I said, it is always so fun to learn history on each state because we're all different. Even though we're all Americans, we are all different in our states. All right, now we're going to move on to the birthday for Iowa. So Iowa became the 29th state on December 28th, 1846. So Iowa is our 29th state to become a state in America. Isn't that nice? I love learning about what state came, what day, what month. You know, it's just so very interesting. All right, now we are on the last part. These are the three ghost stories that I found. They can be sad, they could be twisted, they could be murders, they could be suicidal. However you would look at these stories, you can just imagine, you know, all these stories of how all these people felt in these stories. So let's go ahead and get started with number one. Now this story is called Terror Bridge in Banwell, Iowa. There are many tales behind this royal bridge, but the most popular is rather gruesome. It is said that a woman brought her children to the bridge to watch the trains pass below. Instead, she threw each child over the bridge railings, watching as they were struck and killed before jumping in front of the train herself. Locals warn against stopping your car on the bridge without locking the door and windows, as the woman's spirit may try to throw you off. Visitors who are brave enough to exit their vehicles report seeing strange orbs, hearing voices in the woods, or a woman moaning beneath the bridge, and finding strange handprints on the car windows. Now, I find that, I mean, it is creepy with a ghost, but I find it very, very sad that this mother, whatever she was going through, abuse from her husband, or she was probably depressed, have a lot of anxiety, and people who have chronic depression can be really bad. So, there had to be a reason why she would do that to her children, but that's wrong. I mean, no child does not ask to be born into this world and to be, killed by your own mom, and then her killing herself is just very, very sad, very sentimental to me. All right, moving on, number two. This story is Squirrel Cage Jail. As the only three-story revolving jail ever built, the Squirrel Cage Jail already has an interesting history. Built in 1885 and used until 1969, today in a museum and tourist attraction and featuring many unexplainable occurrences. Visitors touring the jail often report seeing or hearing several ghosts, including that of jail's first resident and a young girl dressed entirely in gray. From opening and closing doors and strange lights to disembodied voices and apparitions to the historical building, we'll be sure to give you the creeps. So, that story was kind of scary, but not, that was kind of mild. I mean, it wasn't really that scary. I mean, it just talking about, strange lights and disembodied voices and apparitions and stuff like that. So, nothing really scary there. But this last story, number three. This story, creeps me out. I'm pretty sure there's a longer story, but this is the part that I have found, and I want to share it with you guys. Now, this story is called the Villisca Axe Murder House. Visitors have reported everything from a door opening and closing on its own, feeling chills and being pinched, to hearing children laughing and playing with toys in empty rooms. Experience these sensations and more in Villisca Axe Murder House, where 8 people, including 6 children, were murdered in their sleep over 100 years ago by an unknown killer. Tour the house in the backyard, cemetery, or make a reservation to spend the night. And that one was kind of creepy. I mean, you know, this unknown murderer came in and slaughtered this family, and nobody could find him, and it's just really, really sad. Again, it involves children, and I love children, and it's just another story that makes me sad, but that's kind of creepy, too, because could you imagine a ghost just coming up and just pinching you and just look back and there's nobody there? Or you're hearing voices, or you're hearing children play in empty rooms that you know you're by yourself, or nobody goes in those rooms. I mean, that would creep me out, guys. That would creep me out. All right, guys, that is my last story. I hope you guys enjoyed the history and everything on Iowa, because I know I learned a lot. Well, not a lot, but most of the things about Iowa. I love learning about our states, and Iowa has pretty interesting, history parts, and for them being our 29th state, that's awesome too. The little ghost stories behind that, well, those were just, little fun things that I like to do, and like I said, ghosts back then, if they could talk, they would tell you a story of what it was like to live back then. And, you know, learning a little bit about their bio also. But like I said, if you live in Iowa and you know more about the bio, or you could tell me more about the bio, just leave me, information down in the description box. I would love to hear. All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. And I hope everybody stays blessed. And I hope everybody stays safe, no matter where you are, no matter where you're at, please stay safe. And I'll be seeing you all in my next video. Thank you for stopping by, and you have a great day. Thank you. Bye.